So what is the plan? What is it that we have worked on? And it really is a we. And I think that our role in it is really at an end. We have given you the best comparative and structural information that we could. But I will say that the Chamber really took the bull by the horns. They really said, we want more, and we want you to position us for more. So it became more than a traditional economic development plan, and that is reflected by these goals. Because the number one goal is to enhance Jefferson City's quality of life. Why is it that? Why is it that? I think goal two helps answer it. The competitive advantage of communities really lies largely in their ability to attract and retain talent. And your ability to attract and retain talent requires you to be the kind of place that young, educated, professional people want to be. It's a place they want to be in, they want to feel comfortable being in. Technology, tolerance, and talent. I'll crib from my friend Richard Floyd here. Those are his three T's. Richard and I have a lot of disagreements, but I will totally agree with him on this point. There has to be a commitment to the growth of technology, there has to be a commitment to talent, and there has to be a commitment to tolerance. And tolerance really here is another way to talk about diversification and diversity and the ability to integrate. We had one focus group. Where's Missy? Someone in the audience is missing. Missy and I had a little mini focus group, and we had it with a group in the city that actually disturbed me. Because at one point they said to me, and I hope I'm not here to, well, actually I do hope I'm here to offend them, because I disagree with them. They said, well, we just don't want, you know, the kind of people that have piercings and tattoos. I want those people. I want them. And if you won't take them, we'll take them in Austin. You can't turn your back on those people. You can't act, they're not like us, so we don't want them. The color of their skin isn't the same. They have tattoos. They may not worship at the same church. Maybe they don't worship at the church at all. Maybe their sexual orientation isn't the same. Maybe their family structure isn't the same. What's your attitude toward them? Is it tolerant or is it insolent? Those things matter. They matter in your ability to develop, retain, and attract talent. The goal three is the more traditional goal, is to stimulate business growth through innovation and attraction. But emphasis on innovation. You have good manufacturing firms here, and they'll be the first to tell you that without innovation in their industries, they can't be competitive. We use the word globalism all the time, but we don't necessarily know what it means. It literally means that if our industries aren't innovating and we aren't supporting that innovation through entrepreneurship and through incentives that match that, then we can't retain them. We can't retain them in the U.S., much less in Jefferson City. And finally, we need to build an organizational infrastructure. We have to be able to do the things that a transformative plan like this calls for. So this now looks at, and I'm not going to read all these words, now it is like an eye test, but the plan is available to you, it's online, and Randy has multiple copies of it. But when we talk about enhancing Jefferson City's quality, well, first of all, why are we talking about quality of place and not quality of life? And I'll tell you why. Those of you who've heard me say this before, I'll say it again. Every community we go to in the United States has the best quality of life. Everyone. And you know what? They do. Because the people you're asking are the people who are resident in that community. They're committed to that community. Of course they believe it. But what? Here's the difference between quality of place and quality of life. Quality of place says, what does it look like from someone who is not from that community? What do you look like to someone who isn't resident here, who doesn't have investment in the community? Are they welcome? Do they feel like they're part of it? So in order to enhance that quality of place, we went through a very detailed process, supported strongly by the Chamber and a concurrent initiative by the Chamber to develop a vision. And these two processes dovetail. And among the most important of the things that we feel as your consultants can be done to enhance that quality of place is to begin to develop a quarter concept, to see a link between St. Mary's and the Capitol and the river, to see that as being connected in some way, and to build a redevelopment district in the community that both has economic value and that enhances quality of place. The most progressive cities in the United States, the ones that have the most vibrant communities and economies, are the ones that embrace the rivers. It's an obvious thing once you see it. Before you do it, it isn't obvious at all. So establishing a West End Redevelopment District and creating a riverfront park adjacent to the Missouri River, we see as critical to your economic success. This isn't like a normal economic development plan that says, let's look at your industrial park and let's talk about what it takes to bring industries to an industrial park. You aren't competitive in that area. But you can become competitive in your area if this and the expanding and leveraging of other amenities becomes part of what the city's goals are. So we looked at and drew some conceptual maps of redevelopment corridors. We took a look at other communities that have done this. Charlottesville, Virginia was one, and I think, Tim, you probably are familiar with this, at the Downtown Mall, which is really now a huge success within Charlottesville. In Lancaster, Pennsylvania, over $1 billion investment to support small business development downtown, now blossoming into boutiques and restaurants and art galleries. So really what you're seeing when you see this transformation take place is communities that say, good enough isn't good enough. It's not enough just to have an economy that can get by. We're looking for an economy that can transform itself, that recognizes the value of young, talented people, and that really strives to be something that it has not been in the past, or that has been in the distant past and needs to be captured. The second goal is about that development and retention and attraction of talent. And you have the means to do it. We wouldn't have recommended any of these things if we didn't believe it was possible. We believe it's possible. We think doing these things can result in change. And the reason that we believe that is because you have what a lot of communities like you don't have. Someone I was talking to earlier before we convened here was saying, well, do you do a lot of work in rural communities? I said, I don't think Jefferson City is a rural community. You have a university. You have a strong community college. You have the state capitol. You have a major river. You have attractions that bring people from throughout the state and beyond. You have the ability to leverage things. And I'm not suggesting. We've done the analysis that tells us that you have not leveraged this. And you have a university that's willing to participate in this. And Lincoln University can and is interested in this. And we are saying that based on our professional experience, that your investment in that will pay dividends. And establishing a university village district is an important first step in that process. The opportunities around St. Mary's and the closure of St. Mary's or relocation of St. Mary's can further be linked to Lincoln University, and not just Lincoln University, but Mizzou as well. And this larger goal of fostering lifelong learning and professional skills development is not all about young people. It's also about baby boomers and the talent that baby boomers bring and what it takes to get baby boomers to invest. What does it take to have people who have roots in this community to invest in that community? Is that out of the question? It is not out of the question. There are mechanisms for doing that. And there are reasons why people who are associated with this community might reinvest in that community. We believe this plan will help that happen. So we have done a conceptual map of what it would mean to to increase the visibility of the university. My first trip here, I wouldn't have known Lincoln was here. I would have driven in, and I would have never known. It's nowhere visible, there's no signage, there's nothing. When I go to the university towns that we work in, it's a strong, visible presence. There are banners, there are signs, there are all sorts of things. And those things have economic value. In Lubbock, Texas, privately funded 325-acre redevelopment area adjacent to Texas Tech. And I can tell you, Lubbock has nothing on Jefferson City. Nothing. Well, it says that it's a Longhorn, I know. Provide new student housing, retail, hotel, conference center. You'll see the commonality of the pattern here. Dayton, Ohio. You feel like, well, Lubbock is Texas Tech, and Texas Tech is bigger. University of Dayton purchased and renovated 200 rundown houses adjacent to the campus. Is something like this possible in Jefferson City? Absolutely, it's possible. Community revitalization and economic development are not two different areas. It's the same theme. And a commitment to it can make an enormous difference. We've also recently completed a master plan to improve neighborhood amenities. They're building a university village. An entrepreneurial center in Independence. You probably know more about this than I do. But that public-private partnership is redeveloping into a wet lab, among other things, culinary terrain. Many of the same things that can be done here, that voices that we've already heard in the community promoting this. In Brighton, Colorado, adaptive reuse of 75,000. So we looked at this. We met with other consultants. We looked at the economic impact of these things. We believe in them. We believe that they're possible for you, and we believe that they will stimulate your economy if you commit to them.